Welcome to FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Spy and the Achilles Sword. Chapter 1. The Mission Begins. In the dimly lit corridors of a clandestine government facility in London, Alexander Callas, a spy with a reputation for his uncanny ability to navigate the treacherous waters of international espionage, received his orders. The mission was clear but daunting: recover Achilles' sword, an artifact of legendary status and immeasurable power, recently stolen from a Greek temple dedicated to the ancient hero. Callas, a man of medium build with sharp eyes that missed nothing, was well versed in the art of deception and intrigue. He had served in World War II, operating behind enemy lines, a background that made him the perfect candidate for this mission. His handler, a stern-faced woman known only as Mrs. Harrow, briefed him on the gravity of the situation. The sword, believed to have supernatural properties, had fallen into the hands of an enigmatic organization known as the Order of Ares, a group shrouded in mystery and rumored to have ties to powerful figures in post-war Europe. The first clue to the sword's whereabouts pointed to Athens, a city still reeling from the ravages of war. As he prepared to depart, Callas knew that he was stepping into a labyrinth of danger. Athens was a city of shadows, where allies were indistinguishable from enemies, and every corner had secrets. Upon arrival, Callas submerged himself in the bustling life of Athens. Under the guise of a weary traveler, he scoured the city's cafes and markets, seeking whispers and rumors about the sword. His first breakthrough came from an unexpected source, a local antiquities dealer named Nikos, who spoke of a mysterious figure seen in the ruins of the Parthenon, carrying an object that glowed with an unearthly light. As night fell over the ancient city, Callas made his way to the Parthenon. The moonlit ruins, a symbol of Greece's glorious past, were now a playground for those seeking to exploit the country's treasures. Navigating through the columns and shadows, Callas encountered a group of mercenaries searching the ruins. A skirmish ensued, with Callas relying on his combat skills to escape, further indicating that he was on the right track. His next lead took him to the island of Delos, an uninhabited island and archaeological site, where ancient Greece's past whispered in the wind. Disguised as an archaeologist, Callas explored the island, uncovering signs of recent activity that seemed out of place among the ancient ruins. It was on Delos that Callas encountered Elena Costas, a Greek national with her own interest in Achilles' sword. Elena, a woman with a fierce intellect and mysterious aura, claimed to be researching the mythological aspects of the sword. Her knowledge of ancient Greek lore and her proficiency in several languages made her an invaluable ally. Despite initial mistrust, an uneasy partnership formed between them, bound by a common goal. Together, they deciphered an ancient text found in the ruins, which spoke of the sword's creation by Hephaestus, the god of fire and craftsmanship, and its bestowment upon Achilles. The text hinted that the sword's power was tied to an ancient ritual, one that could be replicated under certain celestial conditions. As Callas and Elena delved deeper into the mystery, they found themselves entangled in a web of intrigue that stretched beyond the shores of Greece. A clue pointed them towards Istanbul, a crossroads of the world, where East meets West. The city, a melting pot of cultures and a hub for clandestine dealings, was likely to be the next piece in the puzzle of the sword's location. Their journey to Istanbul was fraught with danger. The Order of Ares, aware of their pursuit, sent agents to thwart them. Callas, utilizing his espionage skills, orchestrated a series of misdirections and evasive maneuvers, allowing them to reach Istanbul unharmed but wary of the challenges that lay ahead. In the shadowed streets and grand bazaars of Istanbul, Callas and Elena continued their quest, navigating a city teeming with spies, merchants, and relics from bygone eras. Each step brought them closer to the sword, but also deeper into peril. As chapter draws to a close, Alexander Callas, with the enigmatic Elena Costas by his side, prepares to confront the tangled web of secrets and lies that surround Achilles' sword. In the world of espionage and ancient artifacts, trust is a rare commodity, and the true nature of the sword remains as elusive as the shadows that cloak their path. Chapter 2: The Web of Conspiracies. The journey to Istanbul marked a turning point in Alexander Callas's mission. The city, a tapestry of ancient traditions and modern intrigue, was a nexus of clandestine activities in the post-war world. Istanbul's strategic position between continents made it a hotbed for spies, smugglers, and those seeking to control the relics of history. Callas and Elena Costas arrived under the cover of night, blending into the city's vibrant life. Istanbul was a city of contrasts, the haunting call to prayer mingled with the bustling noises of marketplaces, and the architectural grandeur of its past stood in stark contrast to the scars of recent conflicts. Their first stop was the Grand Bazaar, a labyrinth and market teeming with traders and artifacts from across the globe. It was here that Callas believed they would find their next clue to the whereabouts of Achilles' sword. Disguised as collectors of antiquities, they navigated through the crowded alleys, their eyes and ears open for any mention of the sword. Their search led them to an elderly merchant, known for his collection of rare artifacts. After a series of cryptic conversations and careful negotiations, the merchant revealed that the sword had indeed passed through Istanbul but had quickly disappeared into the black market. He spoke of a mysterious figure, a key player in the city's underworld, known only as the Shadow, who might have information about the sword's current whereabouts. The trail from the Grand Bazaar took Callas and Elena into the depths of Istanbul's underworld. They frequented smoky cafes and hidden meeting places where whispers of political plots mingled with the clatter of backgammon pieces. Each step further entwined them in a web of conspiracies that extended far beyond the theft of Achilles' sword. They learned of a plan to use the sword to ignite tensions in the already fragile political landscape of the region. As they delved deeper, they encountered various factions, each with their own agendas. These included exiled politicians, foreign spies, and remnants of secret societies, all converging in Istanbul with intersecting interests. The complexity of the situation was daunting, But Callas, with his experience in espionage, navigated these treacherous waters with skill and discretion. The breakthrough came when they managed to arrange a clandestine meeting with the Shadow. In a dimly lit room in one of the less reputable parts of the city, they met the elusive figure, who turned out to be a woman of striking intelligence and insight. She revealed that the sword was more than a mere artifact. It was a key to unlocking a series of ancient texts that contained knowledge of great power. The Shadow agreed to assist them, but her help came with a price. In exchange for information about the sword's location, Callas and Elena were to intercept a convoy carrying vital intelligence for one of the competing factions in the city. Reluctantly, they agreed, finding themselves further entangled in the political intrigues of Istanbul. The convoy heist was a high-stakes operation, requiring precise timing and coordination. Callas and Elena, along with a small team assembled by the Shadow, executed the plan with a blend of stealth and force. The operation was successful, but it left them with even more enemies in a city where trust was a rare commodity. With the information obtained from the Shadow, they learned that Achilles' sword was likely in the hands of a private collector, a man of great wealth and influence, residing in a heavily guarded villa on the outskirts of the city. The collector was known for his obsession with ancient artifacts and his indifference to the political games of the city. As chapter draws to a close, Callas and Elena prepare to infiltrate the collector's villa, a mission that would require all their cunning and courage. The web of conspiracies in Istanbul was intricate and dangerous, but within its threads lay the path to Achilles' sword and the secrets it held. Chapter 3. Powers Unveiled. On the edge of Istanbul, where the city's chaos gave way to quiet opulence, stood the villa of Demetrius Sokolov, the reclusive collector rumored to possess Achilles' sword. Alexander Callas and Elena Costas, under the guise of knight, approached the villa, aware that the mission they were about to undertake could unravel more than just the location of the sword. The villa was a fortress, with high walls and patrolling guards. Infiltration required a blend of stealth and strategy. Callas, using his expertise in espionage, and Elena, with her knowledge of the local terrain, found a way through the defenses, evading detection as they delved deeper into the heart of the villa. Inside, they discovered a world of ancient treasures, artifacts that span the breadth of human history. But it was Achilles' sword they sought, and it didn't take long for them to find it, displayed prominently in a private gallery, its blade gleaming ominously in the dim light. As Callas reached out to claim the sword, the room was suddenly flooded with light. They were not alone. Demetrius Sokolov, accompanied by armed guards, confronted them. Sokolov, a man of refined tastes but ruthless disposition, revealed that he knew of their true intentions all along. Callas, in a tense standoff, negotiated with Sokolov. In a twist of events, Sokolov proposed a deal. He would give them the sword if they helped him decipher an ancient text that came with it. This text, written in a forgotten dialect, was said to reveal the true power of the sword. Left with no other option, Callas and Elena agreed to the deal. The text led them to an ancient temple on the outskirts of the city, a place where history and legend intertwined. The temple, dedicated to Achilles, held secrets that had been lost to time. In the temple, they encountered inscriptions and relics that spoke of Achilles' sword not just as a weapon, but as a key to a source of ancient power. The sword was tied to the fate of Achilles, imbued with abilities that were both a blessing and a curse. As they deciphered the text, they learned of a ritual that could unlock the sword's true potential. But this revelation came with a warning: the power was not meant for mortal hands. It was then that Callas and Elena realized the gravity of their mission. The sword was more than an artifact, it was a gateway to knowledge and powers that transcended human understanding. Their revelation was interrupted by the arrival of agents from the Order of Ares, the shadowy organization that had been pursuing the sword. A fierce confrontation ensued in the temple, with Callas and Elena fighting to protect the sword and the secrets it held. In the midst of the battle, the ritual was inadvertently triggered, unleashing a surge of energy that enveloped the sword. The temple shook as if reacting to the awakened power, revealing hidden chambers and ancient mechanisms. As the dust settled, Callas and Elena found themselves in a hidden part of the temple where the true purpose of Achilles' sword was revealed. It was a guardian of a portal to knowledge left by an ancient civilization, a repository of wisdom that could change the course of history. Aware of the sword's immense power and the danger it posed in the wrong hands, Callas made a decision. He chose to seal the portal and return the sword to its resting place in the temple, ensuring that its secrets remained protected. Their mission complete, Callas and Elena left the temple, the sword once again hidden from the world. They had uncovered a truth that was meant to stay buried, a power that was beyond the realm of human ambition. As chapter draws to a close, Callas and Elena, standing on the outskirts of Istanbul, reflect on their adventure. They had delved into the depths of history, confronted forces that they could barely comprehend, and emerged with a new understanding of the past's influence on the present. Chapter 4: Shadows and Revelations. Back in Istanbul, the city's ancient walls seemed to echo with the secrets Alexander Callas and Elena Costas had unearthed. They had discovered the true nature of Achilles' sword and its connection to an ancient source of knowledge. But their mission was far from over. The Order of Ares was still in pursuit, and the revelation of the sword's power had only intensified their determination to possess it. Callas and Elena realized that the only way to ensure the safety of the sword and prevent the Order from exploiting its power was to confront them directly. They devised a plan to lure the Order to a location where they could control the confrontation on their terms. The confrontation was set in the Hagia Sophia, a symbol of Istanbul's rich history and a fitting backdrop for the final showdown. As the Order's agents arrived, expecting to seize the sword, they were met with resistance from Callas, Elena, and a small team they had assembled. The battle that ensued was not just physical, but also a clash of ideologies. The Order of Ares, led by a charismatic and ruthless leader named Constantine, believed in using the sword's power to reshape the world according to their vision. Callas and Elena fought not only for the preservation of the sword, but also to prevent the resurgence of ancient knowledge that could potentially unleash chaos upon the modern world. In the midst of the battle, the sword's powers were inadvertently unleashed, revealing glimpses of ancient wisdom and forgotten histories. The Hagia Sophia itself seemed to respond to the sword's energy, revealing hidden compartments and cryptic symbols that have remained unnoticed for centuries. The climax of the confrontation occurred when Callas faced Constantine in a duel. As they fought, the sword in Callas's hand resonated with the energy of the ancient temple, giving him an edge over his opponent. The duel ended with Constantine's defeat, but Callas chose not to end his life, understanding that the cycle of violence and pursuit of power needed to end. With the Order of Ares thwarted, Callas and Elena faced a crucial decision about the fate of Achilles' sword. They knew that returning it to its temple on the Aegean island was no longer safe. The world was changing, and the sword's power was too great a temptation for those seeking to exploit it. In a decision that would alter the course of their lives, Callas and Elena chose to sink the sword into the depths of the Bosphorus, a place where the currents and mysteries of the sea would guard it. The sword's final resting place in the waters between two continents was a fitting symbol of its legacy, a bridge between the ancient and the modern, the known and the unknown. As they watched the sword disappear into the deep blue waters, Callas and Elena realized that their journey had changed them. They had delved into the annals of history, confronted powers beyond their understanding, and emerged with a newfound respect for the past and its secrets. The story concludes with Callas and Elena leaving Istanbul, their mission complete, but their lives forever entwined with the legend of Achilles' sword. They had prevented a dangerous power from falling into the wrong hands and had chosen to preserve the balance between the old and the new, the mythical and the real. In the world of espionage and ancient artifacts, the line between truth and myth is often blurred, but Alexander Callas and Elena Costas have found a truth worth protecting. Some secrets are meant to remain hidden, their power too vast for the world to comprehend.